March 2014, Liberia is faced with a tragedy, the Ebola epidemic. For the first time in the nation's history, Ebola has struck and Liberians are confused. Bodies of dead relatives, friends and loved ones are thrown in the streets. After a couple of weeks, the virus enters Monrovia, Liberia's capital. Sirens of a few ambulances in the country wheel through the streets, taking people suspected of contracting the Ebola virus to the few Ebola treatment units or ETUs available then. The situation is so appalling, exposing the unpreparedness or weakness of the Liberian health sector, that President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf appeals for both local and international support to help tackle the epidemic.
To you, our community, you have every reason to take ownership, because at the end of the day, the nation and how it goes, how it succeeds, depends upon you. You are the ones that determine the fate of your country.
One organization already playing a role even before the president's call for help is NAYMOTE, National Youth Movement for Transparent Election. The organization has a database of over 4,000 names of beneficiaries and volunteers all over the country. NAYMOTE called these people and sensitized them about the preventive measures against Ebola given by the Ministry of Health.
Because you know that the early symptoms of the virus, you know, include the fever, headache, you know, feeling nauseous, like you want to vomit, and also tiredness in your body.
Because denial was prevalent, NAYMOTE asked some government officials, Representative Edward Kafia of Bourne County and Deputy Speaker of the House of Representatives, Hans Bachu, to add their voices to the sensitization campaign. Here is Honorable Bachu.
I'm calling you so we can talk about small Ebola business. Yeah, I'm going to tell you, when I tell you, I'm going to tell you.
Oh, yes.
All right. The Ebola ability will tell you so that true. So the people know in the village and town that they don't know that the Ebola sickness are rare sickness. They can cure people. And there's no real cure or treatment for the Ebola. So the best to do is to prevent yourself from getting Ebola.
After a while, NAYMOTE decides to go out into 45 communities and with its 300 volunteers, conducts social mobilization. NAYMOTE encouraged people to break the modes of transmission by adhering to the Ministry of Health preventive measures, to seek medical help at Ebola treatment units whenever they show the signs and symptoms of Ebola, and to discourage stigmatization against survivors. NAYMOTE's core message was listen, learn and act. We strictly meant listening to community members' knowledge of Ebola and correcting them wherever they did not understand, and finally acting together. S. Aaron Weawea III is NAYMOTE's program director.
We're making progress. So the government of Liberia and our partner, the government, is saying, look, they fight within a good fight. But if they're not rich, it's time for us to change the message. So we'll hear what the people there have to say. Then we can bring that message back to the people. So the new one, they call it listen, learn, and act. Listen, you must hear the message. You must learn what they're teaching you, and then you must act upon it.
Community leaders were engaged.
Ebola being a deadly disease has brought something and exposed our weaknesses when it comes to our health sector. They are exposed to kind of health system that we have in this country.
A man soon can be sick, that then he say, I'm not touching. I'm not going running. It will be hard. I say, I will do it. If there's anything, let all go.
Yeah.
That's how the whole thing was looking like.
Yeah.
At least the way they have come, they're supposed to share them. Then they come, they do what? Test everybody. Because as you people are seeing, we are the nursery teachers. And not going to see somebody vomiting at 10 days. We were really wrong.
Native people,
yes,
who have certain idea.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody is sick, we can sometimes keep a secret. Me, my mom can room. I can't see nothing I hurry. Then I will let them go to one of the elder. I say, guys, somebody is sick in our house. Then the native will say, man, I'm not going to you. Is it right for me to report the case?
Yes.
We will call our own community togetherness so that we can help to educate them too. Or else it will just be a waste when you come here to do, then everybody passes on their
home. I am Joko Batigier, local Bomo Feng Aswakwara Lupano Fajuta, the Director of Culture and Native Affairs and the High Priest for ATR in Bon County. The Ebola virus impacted us negatively by the wisdom of the president. She was able to invite the National Traditional Council to invite all traditional heads of this land to a conference, for which we pledge to help Ebola fight. Told them to wash their hands. We told them to report any stranger. We told them not to let anybody come and spend time. When they come, they're hungry, you get them food to eat, let them go, they must not sleep. And those instructions were strictly observed. We kept those principles in place.
NAYMOTE collaborated with some organizations in the battle against Ebola. Yotan in Lofa County, General Peace Network in Grand-Jire, and Kodra in Bon County. In furtherance of his goal of reintegration, NAYMOTE brought together several survivors who, along with community members, danced happily, indicating survivors were once again part of their communities. Some survivors also told their stories.
And the members of the community said that the children shouldn't enter the pump. They shouldn't draw water from the pump. I told them no, because the pump for their grandma, and their grandma is there. I'm a nurse. I was working in foyer. I was bringing my family.
You see,
I have to wear the PPE. I have to take care of other patients. I have to take care of my family too. So I used to dress four times. They had to go get it one food. Put food in the other mall. Put food in my mom's mall. While their mother was there already in Vonchema.
I have four symptoms of the Ebola. The hiccup, when it's stumble, the family, and it's so true. But by the grace of God, I made 2 weeks there, and now I'm alive. At the end, the hospital put it, we came in home. I came, the community put it, accepted me very well. After everything, another lady from the hospital died, and the community put said I should go to take care of me. I said, I'm not doing it because I was sick. Nobody was there for me. A lady sacrificed her life to take me at the hospital. So I decided to do it on my own. Personally, I'm with a woman. But in the Stina, sucky.
A community leader in Lofa County acknowledged NAYMOTE's role and encouraged his compatriots to see the need in accepting Ebola survivors back in the communities.
Additionally, to be very frank, myself, sir, I will be afraid. To be very frank, I must be friendly with you.
I like that, yeah.
You see? But later on, through education, they may ought to understand that whatever happens has happened. But they are our children. We should embrace them so that we all can be at one. But you know, as they can't, they want you to embrace them because long time they have not seen you. Mm. And with the common feeling behind it, that the moment you embrace them, you too, you will encounter.
Yeah.
That feeling, sometimes when you are coming, I pretend as if to say, I can be standing, but I pretend I have not seen you. So that's how things have been.
Knowing that the survivors had lost everything that some of them had ever owned, and the disastrous effect the epidemic had on communities, NAYMOTE gave them several items, including bags of rice, gallons of vegetable oil, and cash. And then finally came the day when the efforts of NAYMOTE and others bore fruit. On Saturday, May 9, 2015, the World Health Organization, WHO, declared Liberia Ebola-free. Official program was, however, held by the government of Liberia the following Monday. Here is President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf.
Those who protected us in those difficult days. When the sirens were screaming and the telephones were ringing and people were dying and there was nowhere to turn and everyone was running, we called upon to our bilateral partners, all of whom stood by us in the time of need, our multilateral partners, time and time again. We have recognized and expressed appreciation for the roles played by our national political leadership, for the community leaders. Now comes the challenge of working with our two neighboring countries to make sure they reach the same level of progress that we have reached. Taking a regional approach, reaching across borders to share information, to share experiences, to share talent. We are going to intensify that effort because we know that until they are free, totally free, we are not free. We want to also make sure that we start on the home front to continue our vigilance, our precautionary measures, to continue the advice of our health teams all over the country, to make sure that we do those simple things that we always try to do, like washing hands, like reporting when someone is sick, like making sure there's safe and dignified care when people are reported. To all of you who have come today to join us in this celebration, thank you. Thank you for being with us in those difficult days. Thank you for the partnership and the solidarity. Thank you for helping Liberia.
NAYMOTE, Partners for Democratic Development. Yeah.